Throughout my 10 years of teaching GCSE students, I've seen students go from a grade 3 to a grade 9 in their GCSE chemistry and achieving way better marks by doing what the 1% of high achievers do. But how do they do this? I'm making this video to help you revise GCSE chemistry and get a grade 9, and this applies to all exam boards because there are no exam board specific tips in here. So wherever you are, this is going to work for you. I'm going to explain how the 80-20 rule can help you study less but get better grades, how to memorise the stuff that you actually need to know, how to structure your answers, and the surprising hack that the 1% of top students use to get ahead. So first, let's talk about the 80-20 rule. The 80-20 rule suggests that 80% of the content you learn only leads to 20% of the results, whereas 20% of the most valuable content will lead to 80% of the results. In chemistry, this means focusing on key definitions, key concepts, and key processes rather than having to learn every single detail. For example, instead of spending hours revising every single detail of a topic, focus on understanding the core principles, the key equations, and the key processes. This targeted approach is going to help you retain the information, and it's going to actually give you good detailed notes on the things that you need to know. And to make this even easier for you, Save My Exams have done the heavy lifting and have compiled the key definitions and key concepts and processes into tutorial videos for you. We only have the most valuable 20% of the content that will yield 80% of your success. So a time killer is spending hours and hours writing detailed notes on every single topic. Time saver is using the Save My Exam study videos in order to focus on key definitions and key concepts. Another tip I have for you is to make sure you learn the key experiments that are on your exam. In GCSE chemistry, there are quite a few experiments that you need to be able to remember, and they're really important for the heavy mark questions. During your exams, you're often asked about the practical experiments. For example, when I was teaching GCSE chemistry, there were 8 key practicals that students had to learn. Some teachers might introduce smaller experiments to help you understand certain things better, but it's really important that you focus your revision on the experiments that appear in your specification. These are the ones that are likely to appear in exams, and there are often 6 mark questions based on them. And these heavier 6 mark questions are where you really want to be aiming for full marks to achieve a grade 9, 8, or even a 7. So a time killer is trying to remember every single experiment that your teacher has done in class with you, and a time saver is making sure you focus your revision on the key experiments that are likely to appear in your exams, which is always the ones that are on the specification. Remember, it's that 80-20 rule. So this leads me on to AO1, AO2 and AO3. It's so important to get your AO1 marks, because these are the marks where you demonstrate your knowledge and understanding of scientific ideas. And it's really hard to score AO2 and AO3 marks if you don't have a sound understanding of the scientific material. Within each question, there's also going to be specific command words, for example, describe and explain. You should learn what you should be putting in your answer for specific command words. These tell you how a question should be answered. Additionally, make sure you know the structure of your 6 mark extended answer questions. Often, these are marked by giving you a level first, 1, 2, or 3, and then assigning you a mark. It's so important that you understand how to do 6 mark questions to achieve top grades. We have plenty of YouTube videos on examples of these for GCSE chemistry, which I'll make sure I link below. One crucial tip I have for you is to focus on active memorization techniques and practicing past paper questions. To better help the information sink in, use active memorization techniques like flashcards and diagrams. For example, creating an unlabeled diagram and labeling it yourself can help reinforce it in your memory. Another interactive method is take unlabeled diagrams and label them repeatedly until you're confident you know the material. Remember, physically writing things down really helps you remember it. I cannot stress enough how important practicing past paper questions is to achieve a grade 9. It's a good idea to sort past paper questions by topic, and then you can focus on the topics that you might be weaker in. For instance, you could compile all the questions you've got on atomic structure and tackle them as a group. And this method not only helps reinforce your knowledge of the topic, but is also going to make you familiar with the structure and formatting of the questions that you could expect to get. So to help, I really recommend the Save My Exam study videos, as they've compiled everything on specific topics that you need to know. They offer worked examples, exam-based questions, and key definitions, all things that you need to get that grade 9. Combining these active memorization techniques with doing the past papers is really going to set you up well for achieving success. Now, many people don't actually think this is important, but when you're in lessons, it's so important that you actually listen and ask questions instead of just waiting to get out of there. If you don't know the answer to something, ask your teacher, don't just sit there. If they're explaining something you don't understand, get them to explain it again. That's what they're there for. Focus on lessons and ask the questions, because that's what's going to get you the top grades. And if you don't like the teacher that you've got, then find one that you're comfortable asking. So a few years ago, I taught a student who was getting fives consistently throughout year 10. And then in year 11, his attitude completely changed. He focused on lessons. He didn't seek out opportunities to talk to his friends. He finished the work in plenty of time. So then he was able to ask questions on anything he didn't understand. And often, if he still didn't understand something in the lesson, he would stay behind afterwards and ask then. And he ended up getting a grade 9 in his GCSE chemistry. So remember when I talked about the 1%? Well, this is the hack that only 1% of the students who want to achieve that top grade actually do. And that is learning the content of a lesson before you actually have the lesson. For example, if I'm in class studying a particular topic, I'm going to ask my teacher what we are doing next lesson. I am then going to go home and I'm going to learn the content of that lesson using the memorization techniques that we've discussed here, so that when I'm in the next lesson, it's reinforcing the material and acting as a revision lesson instead of being completely new content. It also is giving you the opportunity to ask any questions that you didn't understand when you were doing it yourself. That is what's going to get you into the top 1% of high achievers. Learning the content before your lesson can make a huge difference to your grade and really allow that content to sink in. Now, if you want to know other proven methods for other subjects, because you're likely doing other subjects in your GCSEs, then watch this video here.